brought you guys to the park today. Left my car at the library since I was already on my way home. Decided to show you guys something different. Do a little very uncomfortable walk through town. I hate all the cars passing by and looking at me. Here we are, we're at the park. Check out some flowers, the gazebo, and some geese. Let's get closer. Oh, look at these guys. Hi guys. I'm gonna draw you today. Cause I brought my sketchbook. Ah, this may have been planned. Hello, sir. Let me give you guys a little turnsy. There you go. They do summer concerts, spring and summer concerts here. Maybe I'll bring you guys one night. Gets really crowded though. Hi guys, don't mind me. Just keep on walking. Oh, I love this. Hey, there I am. I'm gonna sit right here and draw for a little bit. It's like a vlog. Is it like a vlog? Is this what a vlog is? I don't know, but it's gonna be my version of it. All right. Oh, this is so weird for me to be doing. I hope you guys are really, really proud of me. This is so out of my comfort zone. Hi, duck. All right, let's draw some ducks. He's like posing, he's like waiting for me to get my shit ready so I can draw him. Got my sketchbook, got my planner, my little pencil case, which I never actually show you guys what's inside because that's the whole point. Keep the mystery alive. I just stumbled upon this. I love these little library things. Let's see what they have. And I promise I'll bring it back. And I also promise to put some stuff in here. Oh shoot. Oh, this is so cute. Ah, look at that. It's like teeny stuff. Love it. We'll be back. We'll bring some stuff to put in here. I don't think I'm gonna borrow anything. What do they have? Oh, The Short Life of Brie Tanner. I read that. I had it. That is so cute. Love it. Sun came out just in time. I've been here for about 20 minutes. drew some ducks, took pictures of some flowers. I'm gonna take the flower pictures home, back to the studio, and paint those there with you guys. Put together this little vlog situation. Yeah, thanks for coming with me, or thanks for being here with me, spending your time. Hey guys, welcome back to the studio. So I lied. We didn't draw flowers that day. It's much later and I'm getting ready to post this video and I realize, let's chat. I'm excited to do stuff like that when it's actually warm enough to do stuff like that. Do you see me like cozy in my sweater though? I'm bringing you a bit of planning because I know some people are interested in real life, real time planning. I'm planning in an A6 this year. I've been in an A6 since October 2021, if you're 2021, if you're keeping track. Yeah. I like the size. All my to-dos fit in there, and by all my to-dos, I mean the three that I limit myself to most days. I use these dot color markers for, I have three. I have purple, pink, and sepia, and I use it for my two children's activities and stuff, so I don't have to keep writing their names down. and then I use the sepia one for my to-dos or like, you know, things not to forget, stuff like that. These are all my supplies. Like everything on this table is what I use every day. I've got these little stencils that I like. I have four. I have the alphabet one, and then I have this little number one that I've cut down to size. And then I have two by Hobonichi, the green one and the yellow one. I'll talk about the yellow one in a little bit. These are like the perfect size. I've used them here in the A6 and of course in my A5 stuff. And it's just, they fit great. They're like the size of a, you know, business card. So lovely. Then I've got my Sarasa pens. They're all brown. I have the 0.7, 0.5, and 0.3. I use 0.3 and 0.7 as like line variations. And then I write with the 0.5, which I have housed in a white Sarasa. I didn't like the white ink, so, but I did like the look of the barrel. Is that what you call it, a barrel? I don't know. Let's go with that. So this is the one I use the most. I really like the Sarasa pens. They are not 100% waterproof, but I do get away with a lot of, you know, watercolor and stuff once it's dry. I like to, if I'm gonna highlight something, I tend to put the highlighter or the Tombow or whatever first and then write over it. Because even when the ink is already dry and you rub a Tombow over it, it still smears. Which is weird because it doesn't smear like that when I put watercolor. And I'll show you some watercolor pages in a little bit. So there's that. But I do like the pens. Sometimes if I don't use a pencil board, then I've gotten some transfer from the pen. I am heavy-handed though. I've said this before. I'm small and delicate for some things, but when I write, I tend to like dig. I don't know why. Plus, these books get so chunky and fluffy. I don't know. I feel like that also has a lot to do with it. Okay, so I said that we would talk about the stencil. So here I am using it. The yellow one is not my favorite one. I got it mostly because See the little diamonds on the top? It resembles my most used emoji, which is the sparkle, the three little diamonds. And this one had it, so I said, why not? It's convenient. It also has a faux washi rectangle that I like. However, the bursts, I don't really care for them. But I keep it, obviously. And then I have the green one, which I love because it has all the little shapes, but I am looking for a stencil that has just some simple shapes like circles, rectangles, squares, and triangles. So if you know of any, leave them in the comments. Leave your suggestions in the comments. Size-wise, I would like it to be like a 2x3, like a business card type thing. But again, I have the one with the alphabet is a little bigger than that. It's about A6 because it fits in the pocket of my folio. Anywho, it would be really convenient for when I pull like an oracle card or a tarot card to be able to, you know, just go in with my stencil and fill that in. Or also when I'm filling out like moon phases, the stencil that I have for circles is too big to carry anymore. Anywho, in the month of April, I used rub-ons, which you can see right there. I found these at the Dollar Tree. There's a glare. There you go. But I used, you'll see these throughout my pages. It was so fun because unlike stickers, these don't leave, there's no bulk. They go straight onto the paper. Let me tell you, I may want to make rub-ons of my own, you know what I mean? It's really fun. I picked some up yesterday, different ones for the month of May, which we're not talking about May yet. Even though I'm releasing this vlog in May, this is an April vlog. This is all happening in April, the pink moon and all that stuff. So, I love clicking them. It's so obnoxious. As you can see, I've been watercoloring in my journal and I'm keeping it nice and airy and light and backgroundy. I am, or what I like to call, just splashes of color. I'm not creating art in here. I'm trying very, very hard to keep all of my art in my sketchbooks or in my designated, you know, journals. We're done. Are you ready to flip? Let's flip. Thank you.